The sun provides the basis for almost all forms of life, and it underpins our food system. There's a great need for food production. There's also a great need for solar energy, but there's a limited amount of land. Do we use our land for solar energy, or do we use it to grow food? There is a solution.
Agrivoltaics can be a game changer.
One of the amazing things about this technology is it allows us to integrate solar panels into agricultural land, meaning that land doesn't need to be converted to solar panel use. It can be used for agricultural outputs as well. Over the past decade, we've seen a rapid increase in agrivoltaics research and development in East Asia, in Europe, in the US, of course in East Africa with ours as well. The main reason for that is because some of the greatest benefits that can be had from agrivoltaic systems could be achieved in those regions. I'm Richard Randall Boggess, a research scientist working to design the agrivoltaic systems for the different contexts. I've worked on projects in East Africa, and now I'm working on them in Norway, which are completely contrasting situations. The way that the agrivoltaic system works in East Africa, the solar panels are raised above cropland while still using the land underneath for farming.
In Kenya, traditionally we have been doing the solar panel, and the land beneath the panels, we leave it bare. And considering the way we are having a lot of land fragmentation in our country, any space that you're having as a farmer, you're supposed to be utilizing it to ensure that you're having food security.
If people adopt agrivoltaics, they're able to harness power, they're able to harvest water, at the same time growing crops under the solar panels.
Experimented with different types of horticultural crops like tomatoes, peppers. We do French beans for exports, and also the indigenous vegetables, the likes of managu, konde. And what we have been able to know is that crops grown beneath the panel tend to be more productive. That is in terms of the quality and the quantity. Having the shade minimizes the amount of water that is being lost by the plant, which means you're going to use less water to grow the crops under the agrivoltaic system. And apart from that, we're also harvesting the rainwater from the panels, ensuring that we will be having water throughout the production cycle.
So we have gutters that are attached to the lower edge of the solar panels, which means that we can collect the rainwater that's running off the solar panels in a large storage tank and then use it later on during periods of drought. And also, because solar panels are modular and they can be deployed at different scales and also off-grid, it allows for rural communities currently without access to electricity to receive those benefits as well.
In the agrivoltaics farm, 70% of the power we are consuming in a day is generated from the renewable energy. We are running heavy machinery. The pumps are pumping water maybe 12 hours in a day. For an ordinary farmer, they are able to harness power, and they are able to earn a livelihood through selling the crops or even using the crops for their own consumption.
Here, it shows them access to the benefits that electrically powered technology can bring. This could mean a make it or break it for a farmer's livelihood.
We are sharing the knowledge with the community and with any other person who comes to Latte to learn about the agrivoltaic system, be able to understand how it works and the benefit it has to the environment and also to the agricultural production in ensuring food safety.
That matters for those farmers, it matters for those communities, and it matters for us because our food system is interconnected, it's global. So anything that's going to affect those food systems, it affects everybody. Our research and research conducted by others around the world is helping to inform how agrivoltaics can best be implemented and also help us learn what not to do. Here in Norway, it's an organic farm. The previous growing season was grass that was used to feed livestock. They also grow cereals here. But current legislation states that we can't change agricultural land into solar parks. But that means that solar developers are having to turn to other areas, such as forest land. The vertical bifacial systems that we can see here mean that solar panels could be integrated into agricultural land and reduce deforestation. How an agrivoltaic system is designed will completely depend on the local context, including the agricultural practices. From an economic perspective, the systems have to make sense. We could have systems that are raised up with the panels spaced apart above cropland. These panels could be on trackers to track the sun, or even tilt away from the sun to let more sunlight through to the underlying crops. We could have semi-transparent panels that let some sunlight through. We can even have some solar panels that are wavelength selective. So those panels will use some wavelengths of light to produce electricity, and other wavelengths of light will be passed through to the underlying crops to maximize their crop production. And now we're looking into how agrivoltaic systems can be implemented with robotic farming, taking the technology to the next level. Scaled up, agrivoltaics can see large capacity of renewable electricity generation while agricultural practices are still maintained or even improved.
Technology and nature can coexist, and it will make the work easier and also the production will be higher.
There are now thousands of agrivoltaic systems implemented around the world.
It's time we change the way we do our farming and make our farming to be smart and thinking that what could be the impact on our food production or on our food security.